Also, Trump supporter Kayleigh McEnany, former Obama White House advisor Van Jones, and Politico's Eliana Johnson. Maggie, I want to start with you because President Obama, in pretty stark language, said that Vladimir Putin hacked the U.S. election, or at least knew about the U.S. election, ordered the hack. The CIA and the FBI now say they are in agreement that this happened and that the intent was at least partially probably to help Donald Trump. This is a significant moment.
In a year of many significant moments, this is a very significant one. I don't know how much it will do to quell the concerns from people, including Democrats, as to why the president didn't address this more forcefully before the election. The White House has answered that and said they didn't want to look like they were meddling. I don't know how much it will quell the concerns from people about how the Obama administration has dealt with Russia in general. It also sets up a point of conflict between Obama and Trump, with whom he has gotten along pretty well. I think he was asked about when they have last spoken. He said not for a couple of days. It'll be interesting to see what happens and what Trump says about this after the Electoral College votes. There has been an enormous hunkering down within his orbit about this, not saying anything different. He genuinely believes, based on everybody I know who has spoken to him, that this is an effort to delegitimize him in some way. There are people around him who don't think that's going to be a sustainable position past Monday when the Electoral College meets.
Jack Kingston, you are in this orbit. Say it is past Monday. What does Donald Trump say about this now that President Obama has said that Putin did it, or at least...
Well, first of all, I want to say, as I listened to President Obama tonight, and he's very, very careful in his words. He said that there was hacking into the DNC and John Podesta's emails rather than a broad brush, that it was all over the campaign.
I'm not sure that I understand why that matters here. The president was
Hang on a second, Congressman.
He stood up there, the president said, I can confirm that there was this hack, that it was ordered at the senior levels of the Russian government. He confirmed that those were his exact words. Then he said, not much happens in Russia without Vladimir Putin knowing about it.
If I was a lawyer, I would say, Mr. President, you said DNC and John Podesta specifically. Yet you sort of made it sound like they were interfering with the election in general.
He's the campaign chair for Hillary Clinton. But, he's pretty intimately involved with the election.
But where my question would be, though, is if it was such an issue, let's say not a misdemeanor but a felony level, why would you just grab Mr. Putin at a G20 conference in September and say, cut that out? It would have been far more forceful to say, listen, meet me in Geneva. We're going to have an international investigation. Get out of our election and don't interfere with anybody else's. But instead to say, yeah, I pulled Putin aside and said to him, cut it out. He must not have thought it was that serious.
I want to talk about the cut it out moment in just a second. But first, Donald Trump, he is the president-elect. Does he need to say something on this subject?
I think he's going to let the House intelligence. Devin Nunes, Richard Burr, it's going to let the process go through like that. And I think right now he really does have to focus on getting his team in position. There is a narrative about delegitimizing his election. And it was the recount. It was the Electoral College, the targeting after the Electoral College, so they won't vote. The electors won't go with him. It was he didn't win the popular vote. So there is politics in this thing. CIA did not go to the House Intelligence Committee today, which I find to be outrageous.
Richard Burr, Lindsey Graham, they're not trying to delegitimize the election right now. They all say they want hearings. Let me get to the cut it out comments we heard from President Obama, Angela. I have 2 9-year-old boys. Cut it out's the kind of thing I say to them in the back of the car when I want them to stop fighting. It doesn't sound like the kind of thing you say when a foreign entity is trying to hack into your election system.
John, I have to agree with you. If the president did in fact say cut it out, it is not anywhere near as forcefully said as it should have been. I have to address this delegitimizing point. Donald Trump's election, in my mind, is far from legitimate at this point. I have every issue in the world with the fact that Hillary Clinton gets closer and closer every day to 3 million vote, to a 3 million vote lead against Donald Trump. I have every issue in the world with the fact that electors feel like they can't, in some instances, in good conscience, support this man as president. I have every issue in the world with the fact that the intelligence community is questioning the legitimacy of this election. If someone can hack into not just our process, but it's hold on.
Apparently, hacking. That's not saying it wasn't legitimate.
Okay, I am questioning the legitimacy of it. I don't care what they're saying.
You are, but
I am because I am questioning it because there are a variety of factors at this point now that have severely impacted our democracy. And I care about people's participation beyond this election. And the fact that it has been so compromised is a tremendous challenge. I don't know how we hurdled this at this point.
Just to be clear, President Obama was asked directly if he believed the Russians hacked into the vote counting.
I understand.
Or affected the vote counting. He flat out said no.
I understand.
He said,
but nobody's saying that.
I understand that, but the president made a point of saying that, Ben. You think there's a separate issue, Ben?
Oh, no, I was just saying that nobody is saying that the Russians hacked into every voting machine, changed the vote totals, et cetera. I do think that there's a concern here, and I know you probably want to speak to this. I just am surprised to hear Republicans minimizing it.
Right.
Listen, here's the deal. Democrats might want to make hay out of this, might want to jump up and down. That shouldn't be your concern. You're the governing party. You have both the House, the Senate, and the White House. So you have to be above all that and say, I don't care if Democrats or Smurfs or anybody else want to make a big deal about it. It's a big deal to me and my country. And we're not hearing that. That's shocking.
There are two things at play here.
Also hypocritical.
Number one, the Russians hacked the United States. It doesn't matter if it was a Democrat or Republican. It's inexcusable.
But you know who hasn't said that, Kaylee?
It should be dealt with and should be countered.
The president.
President-elect Donald Trump.
When he holds a conference, a press conference, he will be asked about it.
Whenever
and I fully expect
giving
that
a speech,
to be his
he's giving a speech
response.
Tonight.
I fully expect that to be his response. I think he's going to let it play out, as Jack said, let the investigation take place with Congress, who still has not been briefed by the intelligence community after multiple requests. So that's number one. What happened was inexcusable. What is equally inexcusable is for my colleague to question the legitimacy of the election when President Obama, when Homeland Secretary Jay Johnson has come out and said no vote was tampered with, the people had their say, not every vote that was cast was counted and counted accurately, is what the president said. This was a legitimate election. If you have problems with the Electoral College, which has existed for all of time, you can take that up on a separate day in a separate place. But this was a legitimate election, mm-hmm. and no one should question the fact that Donald Trump is the president-elect because he is there fairly.
Angela,
I will do what I want to do, and what I'm saying is that I do not believe this is legitimate for a lot of reasons, including the fact that the intelligence community says that our electoral process was tampered with. I have every right to say the Electoral College. I'm not finished. I'm just responding as John is allowing me to. I have every issue with the Electoral College, and I have since before this election. It does not speak for me. I am not supporting a system that was built on the backs of my ancestors who were slaves. I'm not here for it. And I can say I don't like it, and I can say that I'm going to fight against that system. That is my right. And no, I do not believe that this election is legitimate. That guy is not my president.
But it's not your right. It's not your right to say the intelligence community agrees with you because they don't.
And the intelligence community
and the president
only said that that's listen to him tonight. He only said that there was interference on DNC emails and John Podesta. Now, too much, too far.
You guys are both creating these straw men on the sides here.
You're saying,
John Podesta is part of this election. If they hacked into John Podesta's emails, they hacked into the election. Angela, on the other side, the straw man you're creating is the idea that somehow it delegitimizes the whole thing, which is something that President Obama has said, no, this election, was fair and square, at least in terms of the vote counting.
Let me just say a couple things here. I know you're begging to get in. Just bear with me.
Or